This program is related to the business scenario in the world. So we have given the name of this program is a business breakfast. Business breakfast generally will be telecasted only on every Saturday. But as a part of trial, today we are just launching the trial version. And this trial version will be discussing everything about the international financial and economic scenario. Why economic scenario we thought to launch? Because the people are under cloud. People don't know what will happen to the, what is happening in the area. People don't know what is happening in the world. Why? Because every 10 years, every 5 years, there is a recession. We thought the when the China has risen, we all of us thought that the economy is shifting to the South Asia or the Asian region. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. What happened is that China has fallen much faster than any other country. Either the US economy or it is a former Soviet Union. The collapse of China was much worse and it is more painful for China. Why? China has come as a promise to the world. Everyone thought that the Chinese economy will be the next model of the economy in the world to save the world from the crisis. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. China's growth was 10.5. Before that, it was 8.5. And then later on, what happened? Most of the Chinese employees who have been migrated from the farms, because they were actually belong to the farming community, and they have joined the workforce of the middle class. And many American companies and other foreign Western companies have set up their shop to save money to create margin. Then you will ask me the question, why did they shift from America or in the Western soil to the other country? Because the margin was becoming thin and thin. Then why margin is becoming thin? Because if you need 100 TV sets in the market for one day, for 1 month, for 1 year, then the market is already producing more than 10,000 at a time. So overproduction. Then why overproduction? Because government is pushing with the tax incentives. Why say tax incentive? Because they want to keep the people employed. Then why unemployed started? Unemployment started because the machine has taken over most of the works man was doing from mail delivery. Once upon a time, postal department was one of the biggest employer in the world. Whether it is in the third world country or it is in the developed countries. Now, when the email came, the postal department lost its importance. Then courier companies are parceling many things. At the same time, these days, no one need it because people can directly message. You can send a text message. You can also send the voice video conference. And internet has become very cheaper. And mobile phones are becoming cheapest. And anyone can afford, even a farmer in Indian village or people who sit in the Fortune 500 blue chip companies, head office, they can also use a mobile phone which is more sophisticated and which can do more work of 100 maids at home. You can try, you can record, you can edit, you can telecast, you can directly broadcast to the world. You can do so many things. So when unemployment came, government was in fix. Every government, either it is in the Europe or in the Asia or in even in America, even Donald Trump or it is a Putin or anyone you can say. Then what is the solution? They started giving a lot of incentives for the startups. They have started giving a lot of incentives to the companies which are ready to create more and more employment. They thought that once you set up a new company, you can create employment. Unfortunately, the creating employment is what? You engage people to do some work. You produce things which are more than what you required because then market is overcrowded. So when market is overcrowded, one thing will happen. The people, they won't be able to sell the whole product they produce. The money they invested, the energy they invested, the raw material is going waste. The electricity is produced going waste. Why? Because creating so-called employment. Creating employment should not be the objective of the government in tomorrow. It should be encourage the people to become an entrepreneur. Every man should be an entrepreneur so that every woman will become employed. Even the family members, 4 family members will get a job if you have your own business. So every males at home, at every home should be an employer. He should start his own entrepreneurship. And every home should be a factory. You produce even a small segments of even a missile, even a tank, even a factory, even of a truck, you can produce at home. So your the husband is the chief of the company and the wife is the second chief, and they have a 2 assistant, maybe wife's friend or the husband's friend or a family member of a distant member, plus they can also create a part-time job. So that era over, big factories you set up and you just give a lot of employment. In the end of the day, you get they give a lot of tax incentive to these factories. So from where this tax incentive is coming? The tax is given by the public. So one side public is giving tax, another area corporate is given tax incentive, then income tax incentive government is giving. From where the government will bring all this money? Government want to run its government departments, they need a salary. And they also want to run military, they want to run government hospitals. So the culture of economy has to change. We have been following for the last 100 years a kind of economy that the money will be generated either by a big factories, and it will be distributed for the in the form of employees, in the form of customers, and the customers get a lot of product which is manufactured by multinational companies. That multinational company trend has gone. Once upon a time, Asian countries used to buy so many products coming from multinational company. It was a brand image. They used to trust. Now even a local product has got a quality. Why? The technology has improved and a lot of changes have taken place. Besides, the world is facing a competition from third world countries. Third world country these days produce one of the best products. Though the developed country may be very good in making fighter planes and good missiles or the aircraft carrier, but who need aircraft carrier or fighter plane these days? The people don't want to fight a war. No country. How many countries fought a war for the last 20 years? No country. The only history is that America invaded into Iraq. It was not the invited war, it was imposed war. The war was imposed on a country which is very smaller, and it has been done by 24 countries who is imperialistic, and they have created a lot of ruckus in the world. Now the entire Middle East and the entire world is suffering from terrorism because of the revenge. So creating employment should be rational. Though I have suggested a new theory of economics. So far it was the theory means infinite profit theory. As much as profit you create, that was the theory. Now I am suggesting a new theory with this video, with this program, IBTN's Business Breakfast. I am saying, everyone, I am suggesting is that this theory is that optimum profit theory. What is optimum profit theory? I am suggesting. Means every company or every corporate has to withdraw from the market once they achieve a specific target. So that this is like birds or animals. Once they eat stomach full, they take a little bit mouthful and fly away, leaving behind the food. That is the law of the nature. The same theory. The theory is that any company which makes 30% profit and 10% growth, as soon as they achieve that target, they have to keep only this much target. After that, they have to withdraw from the market, leaving behind the rest of the market space to the other companies, so that every company will thrive. The market should be like a forest. Every plants will grow side by side and it become a jungle. Now what happened? The infinite profit theory is that one company will grow and acquire other company, and it will be like a banyan tree. Only under the banyan tree, no grass will grow, no tree will grow, no bush will grow. This theory is coming. That has to go. It should be optimum profit theory. One, you have a target. The company should grow 10% in 1 year, and the company should make a 30% profit. As soon as you reach that target, they have to withdraw from the market so that the other company can sell their product and they can achieve the same target. In this, you need a government regulation. Most probably, according to me, my belief is that optimum profit theory will save today's economy. Now you see, every 10 years there is a recession. Why recession is coming? Because my man has to have a lot of requirement from oxygen, water, dress, shoes, and you need a partner in life after a limit. When you are a student, you need books. All these things are already invented, discovered, and produced and available readily in the market. So now everyone is investing only in one thing, is that IT sector. IT is a virtual world. Anytime it will collapse. Every IT product is coming, is not surviving, not more than 2 years. Then another product is coming. So what happened? The entire IT sector has become a graveyard of immature and over-invested products. And these products has created, spoiled or ruined or overused or exhausted the capital in the market. The money doesn't come from the sky. It has been created by someone in the form of profit, in the form of labor. So what we would suggest is that optimum profit theory, everyone has to have a 10% growth, 30% margin. Once they reach in an year, they have to withdraw from the market so that other product can be sold, other company will thrive, they will also achieve the same target, they will live. Now, multinational companies, what they do? They try to create a maximum profit, 210% profit, 500% profit, 800% profit. So, how did they achieve it? Killing the small companies. They are unable to compete. They don't have money for advertising. They don't have money for hiring their top-class managers and marketing team. So killing small companies or acquiring them, these big companies have become single monopoly. That has to go. Optimum profit theory is the best theory for the next 50 years, I believe. Secondly, why companies are becoming lesser and lesser profitable? Because so many profit, so lot of product, and people are started buying only the things which they require. They stopped buying for conspicuous consumption. What is conspicuous consumption? Conspicuous consumption is that people try to buy the things to show his neighbor and his friend. Now, no one wants to show anyone. Everyone say, I am okay, you are okay. So, in this theory, the people have changed. Because the last recession, so many people have committed suicide. They lost a job. Then, one thing I have observed in the market is that as soon as the recession came and created problem, that previous recession was more painful. Why? Food inflation and recession came together and they devastated the world. And the people suffered both in Asia and even in the developed countries. America suffered most. China thrived, but China now paying a lot of price. What I would suggest is that produce what we can consume. Take the order, pre-order and produce only that much. So that we know that how many jobs we can produce by the manufacturing sector. The rest of the sector, we can allow the people to become an innovator, invest money for innovation and convert every home, one room in every home into a laboratory and convert every home into a factory, convert every man at home as an entrepreneur, give him loan and convert his home into a factory and let him produce what he innovate, what he discover. So that way the world will become an innovation hub. They will produce more and more new product that would solve the existing problem. Still, we have so many problems. We don't have an effective medicine to cure cancer. We don't have effective medicine to cure diabetes. We don't have effective medicine to save ourselves from AIDS. And if one disease is cured, another disease come up in the form, another form. The nature will send another kind of a virus or bacteria in the name of another disease. So man would always suffering from some or the other kind of disease. So our objective should be innovation. Every individual should be an innovator. Every individual should be an entrepreneur instead of a job seeker. The time has come to avoid over depending on the big factories. Factories, the time is over. Now everyone is looking for miniature product. They don't need a tank. They don't need a fighter jet. They don't need aircraft carrier. All these have become a status symbol of a big country. That is over. For the last 20 years, there was no war except a war is fought by America and in Iraq. It was an imposed war. Again, I am telling you. So, today's business breakfast is launching and this is on trial basis. and we will be coming up in a big way. And I would suggest all of you, please subscribe below by pressing the button, subscription button, and start subscribing this program. And one day someone asked me for the last week, who is the real owner of IVT Studios? I told them, the audience. So it is your channel and it is your voice, it is your world, and it is a channel that is going to tell you the truth, what is happening in the world, and it will tell you the right direction. It will tell you not to fight a war. Let all of you, every country, every, whether it is a Middle East or it is in the West or it is in the Asia, let everyone live peacefully, and let the prosperity come to everyone's home. Let a smile bloom on everyone's face, and let peace prevail everywhere. Let happiness will be the norm of every morning, not the sorrow, not the war, not the blood, not the bleeding. So we have to solve the existing economic problems faced by the old world. For that we need a new economic theory, and I am suggesting optimum profit theory. This theory may solve the today's problem. Every country, every company will survive. Even a small company will be able to sell their product. But once someone who already made enough profit and withdraw, and every male become an entrepreneur, then he can generate for employment. This will again add more employment in the world. So we don't have to give a lot of incentive to the factories and the companies. It will instead that tax money can be used for the welfare of the world, and hospitals infrastructure will increase. So with this, I conclude IBT, International Business Tribune News, launched Business Breakfast program. And once again, I request all of you, please subscribe to this program on YouTube and encourage us. This is your channel. You will always hear a solution for the problem the world is facing, you are facing, your neighbor is facing, your country is facing in economical issues. At the same time, this problem should not be a prevailing cancer. If we can solve today's all economical problems in the world, if you don't depend on the statistics. So I would suggest everyone, please subscribe to this program, and I would like to thank all you viewers for viewing this program, IBTN's Business Breakfast. Business Breakfast program will be only in the weekend, but at the same time we are launching everyday news and daily news headlines and daily news review will be there. And at the same time we have two program. One is IBTN's Business Breakfast and this IBTNN's Good Morning World. This will be the weekend program because we need more material and more information to present this program. So please subscribe it. And I would like to thank you. We will make sure that this program will be very interesting, very informative, very useful for all you audience. Because again, I am telling you, IVT Studio is owned by you audience, not by me, not by the investors. And we will build it as a real international studio. And you will have our voice everywhere. And please subscribe it. And thank you for viewing IVT Studios, IBTN's Business Breakfast. Thank you once again.